Assalamu alaikum students, how are you? Hope you're doing fine and staying safe. Well, before the school closure, we were reading a topic named forces and movement. It was unit 6. We have learned that force is a push and a pull. Now in this topic, in this unit, we are going to understand how big or how small a force can be. Now just a quick recap, what is a force? Force can be a push and pull. You can push the things to move. You can pull the things to move. Now, there are many kinds of forces that we see every day. For example, when you open the refrigerator door, you are using a small force by pulling on the handle. When the wind blows, it is a strong or a big force that can pull back on your clothing or push back our hair onto our faces. Some forces are small and some are very big. If you look at your learner's book page number 62, you can see a boy pulling three kinds of toys. In the first picture, he is pulling, you can see a boy named Omar pulling his toy car with an elastic band. You can see that elastic is not stretched. It is because that the toy car has wheels, and the toys with wheels use small force to move. In the second picture, you can see that he is pulling a rocket. As you can see here, that the elastic is a bit stretched. Why do you think this is happening? Well, it is because the bigger and heavier than car. Rocket is bigger and heavier than car, and it has no wheels. So it is using a bit more force to pull a rocket. In the third picture, you can see Omar is pulling a horse. Well, most of the kids may have this kind of a horse to ride on, and we all those students might have known that it is made of wood, and wooden toys are even heavier than plastic. So elastic is more stretched. It means that it is using more force to stretch a wooden toy. So what we have found out by looking at these pictures, we have found out that a lighter object needs less force to move than a heavier object. For example, you can push an empty box easily, but a filled box would be harder. It would need more force to move. So heavier the things, bigger the force. Lighter the things, smaller the force. Here's a video to help you understand how big force can work. It's an elephant pulling a tree. As you can see, an elephant is trying hard on a tree, and he is using his mighty trunk and mighty feet to pull on the tree. So students, hope you have enjoyed the video. Now look at your learner's book page 62 again. You can see three pictures. In one picture, a child is using a small force to pull a sledge. And what is a sledge? Sledge is a vehicle used for traveling or for transporting loads over snow or ice. You can see a boy is easily pulling a sledge because there is nothing to carry on. In the second picture, you can see a bigger force is needed to pull this vehicle. As you can see, it is quite a huge machinery, and the vehicle has so many wheels. It means it is using a bigger or larger force. In the third picture, you can see a volcano. A volcano has so much force that it can blast a large rocks high up in the air. So, to understand it further, you could try these activities at home or by yourself. You can try pushing a dining table. You can try pulling or pushing a chair. You can pick up the empty bottle and check if it's a bigger force or smaller force to hold it. And you can hold and pull a bottle filled with water to check if it's a bigger force, medium force, or tiny force. So students, you must remember, heavier the things, bigger the force, lighter the things, smaller the force. Hope you have enjoyed and learned, understood this topic. We have given you a small assignment of true and false and the activity book of page number 35. See you on Wednesday. Thank you.